Hello friends, Kishan is here again and welcome you in this video tutorial. In previous tutorial, we have learned how to configure SSL on a Spring Boot application with a self-signed certificate. In previous video tutorial, we have created a self-signed certificate using key tool, and that comes with the JDK bundle itself, right? So in this video tutorial, we'll learn how if anybody wants to access our website by using HTTP protocol, then automatically that should redirect it to the HTTPS port, and how we can implement that functionality using a Spring Boot, that we are going to learn. So if you did not watch my previous video tutorial, then I request you to go and watch my previous video and then come to watch this video. In previous video, I have shown how to create SSL certificate using key tool. So I'll use the same example which we had created in our previous video tutorial, and we had created a self-signed certificate, SSL certificate, and that we kept in his resources directory, and we had mapped these things through a Spring Boot related properties, right? We have specified the server port, key store password, and key password, etc. And we were able to access our RESTful website through HTTPS protocol, right? So now I'm going to create another project. And that is I'm copying this project, and I'm going to create another copy of this project with different name. And at this time, I'll give a Spring Boot, Spring Boot web, redirect from HTTP to HTTPS app, something like this. Web app. And let's click on the OK. So just we are going to create another project with same content which we had in our previous video, and we'll continue with there itself. Now Spring Boot is trying to download all dependency from the Maven, and now error has gone. Now what I'll do, I'm going to as we want to when anybody wants to access our application using HTTPA, then we want automatically that should be redirected on HTTPS. So let's first try to access this application using HTTP, then see whether we are able to access or not. So as this project we have configured, that should be accessed based on the HTTPS protocol. So if you try to access using HTTP protocol, then this will not be accessible. So let's try it out. So here I'm going to write http://localhost/8080 and welcome. So basically I'm trying to access this RESTful API. Right, so if you try to access that, this will not allow you to access, because this should be accessed through only HTTPS protocol on 8443 port. So if you try to access on HTTPS protocol and 8443, then you will be able to access, but this will show some warning saying that this certificate is not trusted because we have generated using key tool and that is recommended only for the development and testing purpose. Right, so there are a lot of company which is working as a security provider, so you can buy some trusted security and you can use that kind of certificates. So in that case you will not get any kind of a warning, but here this port we have to write explicitly, that's the problem. So if what I want, if anybody wants to access this URL like using HTTP and 8080, that should be redirected automatically on HTTPS with port 8443. So that's the thing we want to set up. So first of all, we need to create a configuration class that I'm going to create in the different package, and that package name I'm going to specify com.infotech.config. So we have created this package. Here I am going to paste a class. That code is already I have written over here, and let me explain you this code, how it is going to work. So here basically we'll have to create a class with any name, meaningful name, and that class has to annotate it with @rate configuration. Then you need to configure a method which should be annotated as @rate bin. That means instance of this guy is, embedded servlet container factory is created, and that will be registered with the Spring container. That's the meaning. And bin name would be the whatever is the method name, that would be your bin name. If you want to specify the some specific name, then you can specify those things in this over here bracket. So here basically we have created instance of Tomcat embedded servlet container factory. So this is a class, so you can create an object of this guy. So I have created an object of this fact, Tomcat embedded servlet container factory instance, and this class is having a method is called post process context. So I have overridden this method within this class. So basically we have written an anonymous class for this guy. So here you can see we have written anonymous class of this. So bracket starts here and closing here, and this closed bracket is end with the semicolon. And so in this class we have a method is called post process context. So that method basically we have overridden to achieve some new functionality. And inside this post process context we have created an instance of security constraint. And security constraints, we are setting user constraint as confidential. This is mandatory. And again, we have created an instance of security collection. And security collection, we are setting @patterns /*, means whatever request is coming from the slash or request, we want to keep as confidential. And in constraints, we are adding this collection, whatever we have created over here. And finally, in this context, we are adding this context constraint object. And again we have a Tomcat container factory, and there we are adding, just I'm calling add additional Tomcat connector. So we want to create some additional connectors, right? So we have two connectors. One is HTTP that runs on the 8.0.0, and we want to create another connectors which is basically valid for the HTTPS and which runs on the I want to run on the 8.443. So here we call a method is called add additional Tomcat containers, and we are calling this local private method which just I have created over here. Here we are creating an instance of connectors, and there we'll have to pass qualified name of this class, right, which is provided by the Apache, right? And here connector.setScheme I am passing HTTP, as I'm telling HTTP should connect with 8.0.8.0. So here you are free to choose any port. Here I have chosen 8.0.8.0. And what I want, if anybody wants to try to access my website with HTTP with port 8.0.8.0, then that should redirected on the 8.443. And what I'm telling, connector.setSecure false, right? So this is the class basically we'll have to write. Now after I'm going to kill this server, and let's restart this application again. So I'm going to restart it again. So only you need to create this class to create additional connectors. And if you go to the Spring Boot documentation website, then they have given you a lot of things how to create the multiple connectors. So you'll get a hint from there itself. Now my application is started, and if you go to the console, Eclipse console, then you can see Tomcat started on ports 8 that is 8443, that is HTTPS port, and another port is valid for the HTTP protocol, that is 8080. So now we have two connectors, right? One for the HTTP, another for HTTPS. Now if you try to access my website by using HTTP protocol, http://localhost/8080/welcome, then this will be automatically redirected to the HTTPS. See, you don't need to write this port manually as we did in the earlier example, right? Same you can test from another browser as well. So I'm going to use another browser as so http://localhost this URL, and you can see you have navigated over here, and here we are able to access our RESTful API, and here you can see saying that invalid certificate, and if you want to view the certificate, then you can check this certificate issued by and I think while creating the certificate we had given our first and last name, that name, and valid from this date to this date. This all information we had supplied while creating the SSL certificate. You can get the details, what's the version, serial number, what algorithm we have used to create this issuer name, right? Valid from, to, subject, public key, etc. These details you can get it all here. So I hope you enjoyed learning this video. This code I'm going to put on the GitHub, and GitHub location will get in the video description itself. Guys, if you have any questions or any query or any feedback related to my YouTube channel, then you are free to post below to the video itself. I will try to answer those queries as soon as possible. And if you like this video, then please subscribe my YouTube channel. And thanks for watching this video.